Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play series for Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. I am S.A.N, and when we last left off, we were mostly just exploring lands of Hyrule down here and experimenting with the fusion spell and finding out ways to make magic stabs, for the most part. The first thing you may notice is that I'm not exactly where I left off, which is in the shrine. I did that off screen because, for the most part, it was just going to be me going back and forth and trying to get the strategy I was using there at the very end to work. So I spared you all having me to see that. It literally was just me trying to get that ball to fit right where it was, where I wanted to go. It did not take very long, but it took about 15 minutes, and I didn't want to have to start the episode off doing that. So we're ready to continue at this point. So there is a fairy fountain right over there. I don't have a lot of rupees at the moment, though. Last time we did this, it took 100 rupees for the initial one. I don't have that currently. But we can't go but check. I suspect it's still going to require money. Well, at least now I know where it is, so I can come back when I do have the rupees. Also, I'm probably planning on heading to the depths today, because we haven't done that yet. And it'll be interesting to see. Alright, so how much is this fairy going to charge us? No? Alright, that's different. So, something to do with a flute. Well, there are flutes in previous Zelda games. We don't have one. Now, mind you. However, there is something that looks like a stage setup over here, so is there something to do with that? Did. No, well, that's really far off. Basically, this region. Alright, well, that is unlikely to happen anytime soon. I'd also like to get these remaining shrines that I have found. I already made a car, in case you missed that last time. It did not work out very well. Apparently I missed. Delete that pin and head for the actual shrine. More fire fruit. And there's another tower. So I've definitely gone off the beaten path here, but that's part of the fun of these games, is doing that. I've gone nowhere near the main story, which is why I'm kind of thinking I should get back on that. Alright. So, I'm pretty sure the depths is important to the story, or at least the game. But I'm also interested in its kind of a side aspect of it. But it sounded very interesting, so I want to head that way next. Eventually. Because I have to... Good grief. Is it all the way up? Yeah, it's all the way up there. Octorox! I hadn't seen any of those yet. I was wondering if they were in this game. Alright. So far that's my plan as far as I can tell. Cork. Gather these shrines, try and map out this area with that tower, and then head to the depths. Get back here. I have to find Hetsu at some point to cash those in. Also, the other risk I keep running into when I go off the beaten trail like this is I keep running into monsters I may not be able to handle. Okay, there's an electric wizrobe. We ran into our first wizrobe in the last chapter. Oh, good grief. Is that even further away? Stalfos. I haven't run into any of those yet. Sure. There we go. They've been in every game so far, so I expect them to show up, but... Well, I'm getting further and further away from that tower. I was gonna say, it looks like some sort of caravan. We've run into a few of those before, though. Alright. Oh, yeah, another one of those flying wyvern-like creatures. Let's see if I can avoid that. Goats. Yeah, they constantly attack you in the old games. The previous game, anyway. Alright. Let's see. Now there's one of those islands in the sky above us. It's starting to rain. Cattle. Whoa! Easy. There we go. A lot of apple trees. Sunapan Shrine. Alright, let's see what this one has to offer. That game is lagging again. Missing Pathways. I assume we start with this. Not sure how we're supposed to get to that just yet. Does that have something to do with it? As soon as that goes there, then we phase up through that with a send. Ah, there we go. Fairly straightforward, this one, I think. Here. There we go. Yeah, that was straightforward. Three, one more. I have to decide what I want to get next. Heart container or stamina missile. Because I haven't worked on my stamina at all. And it was quite handy to have a fair bit of stamina in the last game. Plenty of these. Alright, let's go get that tower. Alright. Or is that the same one I was at before? That's the one I was at before. That's a monster camp. I tried getting in there before and I died. So let's leave it there for the moment. Lookout's Landing. Still don't really have much to sell, so... Treasure jelly. Hang on, I'm collecting the rupees. I'll get to you in a moment. Some sort of monster cave? Whoa! That was straightforward. Ooh, more long sticks. I don't think I'm going to need this. I don't really... Horblin Claw. Spiky Spear. I can't carry any more melee weapons. I am quite liking these staves, or spears, I guess. I sold all of these off the last time. Well, might as well start collecting them again. I already have a lot more of them. Alright, one more job for this. Can I drop that chair? Alright. Amber. Not really been using that. Another thing I have yet to find a use for. This is an actual spear. A traveler spear. That's fine. Oh. Is this going to turn me into a giant lightning rod? Because it did that last time. That's a yes. Apparently this won't. I'll use that for the moment. so it should just be around this way. And yet more things are falling out of the sky. Including lightning bolts now. I'm still not entirely sure if there's anything you can really do with those yet. There's a lot of trial and error in this game, which I do enjoy, because that means there's a lot of chance for you to play around and try it out what works and what you enjoy using, but also means you're probably missing a lot of stuff as I go by here. I think they've upped the thunderstorms from the previous game. I don't think they were this bad before. Oh, it's one of the ants! Oh no! It's raining! The fire will not work! Thunder seems to have stopped now. The paraglider makes the same sound an umbrella does when rain falls on it. That's a nice touch. I do not believe there is any real way up this apart from climbing up there. Have to wait for the rain to stop. There's no ascend points, really. I guess I'll get a little altitude over here, and then maybe try gliding down. Maybe some of the way. He knocks. I was wondering if they were going to be in this game or not. Turns out they are. Which is good, which is interesting, because I like them. They're bad for me at the moment because I really cannot take them on. The rain is really cutting into my ability to climb up there. Look, you're a tree. I'm not fighting you. Try a different approach. Let's try going up from there. That looks at least close to the right height. Nope, this isn't going to... Oh, wait, if I lie about it, maybe here. Maybe I can ascend the rest of the way. Good enough. Ishodag Shrine. What's the puzzle this time? A windy device. Okay, so we're using... Alright, are we supposed to... Alright, that was straightforward. I just have to make a boat. I've also noticed that these Zonai devices seem to provide infinite charge, basically, when inside these shrines. Place it underneath. All right. Well, it's probably good practice anyway, because I have quite a few of these fans at the moment, I think. Oh, no, I'm out of those. Put there, please, until so I can get this. An opal. Oh, I can sell anything else. One appears insufficient. Maybe I have to use both of them. Try bringing... Well, I have four of them. That's the most I can use here. Alright. While I'm over here, I'm going to grab number four, just in case I need all of them. I hope I don't need all four of them. Quite strong fans, apparently. Actually, that's a good point. Maybe I have to attach them to the side instead of underneath. Oh no, come back! Come back! Alright, well, it's up there now. Once again, almost certainly not how I was meant to do that, but it works. Alright, so apparently, that's a lesson learned. Those things do not work when placed underneath. You have to place them on the sides. Alright, and that's number four. I never found out what to do with those shooting stars in the last game, so... Getting further and further away from the current area I want to explore, so... Let's travel back to Lookout Landing. I really wanted to take a look at the depths. And more importantly, so we'll choo-choo jelly. Looked around for a goddess statue down here. Restocked arrows. Well, let's see if I can.
Hey. Thank you.
I can easily find more of those. Alright, how much are these arrows? Let's buy this hood so I have fun. Still no sign of a goddess statue anywhere down here. There's that weird Poe one that he was asking about, but I haven't found any Poes yet, so. Apparently I can't gonna look for this. I can, but I mean I have Alright. I know where that one is. I was not going really going there. Oh god, a statue is hard to tell. Alright. There probably is one. But I'm just gonna go back to the one I know about. And after this, we'll head to the depths. It's entirely possible I will not be able to handle what is down there, but there's no way for me to know that until I head there. I feel like I'm a bit more comfortable with the amount of hearts I have currently, so I think I will upgrade my stamina this time. Doing for shields. I don't really use shields that much, but I'll take this one. I don't really want a rusty broadsword. Thank you. Yes. Let's go meet Robbie. Avoid the corrosive red-black stuff. The depths. Yes.
Oh.
All right. I'm going. I have a few. Some sort of firefly? Alright. I made a... Yes. I wanted to give these a try. Alright, so I'm giving off my own light source now. Can you imagine how bright that would be after total darkness? Alright, we seem to have turned the lights on down here now. Well, that was easy. I imagine it's only going to be for the small area. Oh, but it's a travel point. That's handy. I don't have many of those. I've been selling them off. Well, I have some of this glowing effect, so hopefully that's enough. All I'll have to find him first, start that. Huh. Difficult to tell friend from foe. Does that mean I can make monsters fight each other? That'd be interesting. Puff shroom! Bitter powder. Cloud of. Okay, some sort of cover, I guess. Now, these have both sound like they're useful. Alright, it's gonna be very easy to get lost down here by the looks of it. Nearing the edge of my light field. Okay, they look, they're covering this stuff. Yeah, I'm kind of glowing. That does probably present a problem for stealth. I'm going to have to try my hand at dealing with these things eventually. This is the zonite ore I need. One more. What is that? Some sort of cyclops frog. Large zonite. So it doesn't just give me more, it's just the fact that it counts as something separate. Apparently, they shouldn't have been using all these tools to harvest this stuff. They should have just been bashing their heads into it. So, whoa! Oh, you guys also dropped zonite. Oh, and bright bloom seeds. The bad news is I think I'm lost now. Alright, well now that I know these things aren't really that big of a deal. Let's head back and try and deal with that other group. Special arrow either, that was just one of them. Hit me. Doesn't heal down here, I suspect. Well, I did also make something that helps with that. Yeah. There we go. There we go. Oh yeah, I could have tried out that muddle shroom. Thank you. This thing's about to break, by the looks of it. Is that all of it? At least in this area. Those roots. Ah, there's Robbie. Good. I ended up heading the right way. Largely through happenstance. It's funny how often that comes up. I assume that is the purpose. Stop! Finally me! You wandered off on your own! Yes, it does. Can start identifying things again. I mean, I took a picture of it. Alright, by sounds of it, that's all he really wanted us to do down here. Test out something with the camera. I couldn't. Alright, so we can add materials to the compendium now, by the looks of it. How about zonite? Can I... No. Turns out. How about this? Yes, but not the sapphire, apparently. I assume at some point we're going to get to the sensor again, which will let us search for this stuff. Which was very handy last time. Arrokuda. Alright, so that's what those things are called. Well, at least I can, fill in my compendium now with some entries. Alright, I want to try and get some more zonite. See if we can play that game. I just prefer to play it this way. These constructs, though, do not last nearly as long as I had hoped. Oh dear, I think those are explosives. Came awfully close to... Goblin sledge broke. Alright. The goblin bows are not very good. Alright, hang on. No, not that. Iron box hammer. As humorous as that would be, I'm pretty sure that's better. Well, apparently I'm going to need an awful lot of this. The amount I'm being given here is any, indication. camera doesn't seem to recognize those as an item. Then again, it doesn't recognize Zonite as an entry, so... It does seem to have some limitations. Traveler's Bow, that'll be nice. In fact, they seem to last a bit longer, these contract ones, so I'll save that for the moment. Alright, and I'm curious to see if these explode. And that was terrible. Yes, they are explosives. They're timed ones, though. Alright. Let's head back to Lycos Landing now. Oh, we have to explore the depths a little bit. Pony points. Us to head towards Hebra next. Or... interested in those because I'm pretty sure they're going to break quite quickly. I quite like making my improvised weapons at the moment. Alright. Now, if memory serves, there was a place up here where they were processing zonite. A crystal refinery. Let's go take a look at that. Let's see what this can be used for now. Hello. Okay, so I need to process the zonite to make those pyramids, which we've seen. So it's a bit of a two-step process by the looks of it. But that's fine. There's the dragon again. Large zonite charge. Well, according to this, mine should be around here. I think that's it right there. All right, let's give this another try. Maybe I'll get something good out of this. Don't really need those anymore. Oh, good. Some more fans. Oh, yeah, there's still that thing over there, which I haven't taken a look at yet. Alright, camera. Flex Construct 1. What is this thing? Construct composed of interconnected blocks, make up the made by the zonai with advanced techniques and magic. You can rearrange the blocks to change its shape, and that sounds interesting, to provide sufficient energy to power its gigantic form and the massive store. Okay, so that's going to be fought to get zonai charges. I've not heard. Looks interesting. I'm not sure I'm ready to take it on yet. I have four more. Alright, well, we're up here. We can make some more choo-choo jelly. Is this... This is the wrong cave, isn't it? Yes, it is. More of this stuff while I'm here. Oh, wow. Yeah, I'm not too concerned that I sold off the, all the bright bloom seeds I've found up until this point. I'm going to need a... Alright, there we go. Alright, a ruby. Well, it's not a sapphire, but can I... No. That's unfortunate. I was hoping I could tag sapphires so I could search for them to make more of my ice staves. That's fine for the moment. Take you out of the fight quickly. The sword's finally on the verge of breaking. Fortunately, I have the materials I need to make another one. This does look more like what I remember it being, a mining cave. Alright, so this should be where I can refine the zonite. Hello again, I'm back. Replacement for this thing that's about to break. Here we go. Alright, let's go see how much of this stuff it takes to make these. Crystallized charges. Yeah, that wasn't too bad. Alright, now the next question is, how many of these, here, let me give you a hand with that. I'm not threatening you, I'm just trying to help you process that. So it looks like it's going to take them a little while to process all the zonite I just sold them. I almost got back everything I needed. I used, so that should be fine. Alright. Let's go back and talk to the one in charge of converting these things into powering up my energy cell by the sounds of it. And let us see how much this is going to take. I somehow doubt it's going to be 10, because I just said there wasn't enough. There's more than enough to get that, I think. Steward construct. They're producing. 100 of them! Okay, so I'm a tenth of the way there. Okay. Well, I wasn't expecting to be 10. I also wasn't expecting to be 100. So, it's gonna take a little while by the sounds of it. The good news is, so, so it took 30 to get this, so I'm going to need a total of 300, so 270 total just to get one, and I do not have that much yet. Unless this counts as more, I don't think so, it's separate by the looks of it. Alright, well, it was worth checking on that while I was here. I see a either it no longer allows you to do that, or I'll start jumping off of this. This isn't one. No, it is. I just have to jump from. I just have to not cheat, basically. Go back this way and make a bit more ice choo-choo jelly so I can keep using it, because I use a lot of it in combat, I'm sure you've noticed at this point. we go. No, apparently this is not too high up or too much material to phase through. Oh, well, I've been here before anyway. Okay, a few more Zonite devices while I'm here. Time for everyone to go back to work. Ah, another place I can then transform my choo-choo jelly. Yes, very impressive. Probably making. There we go. Switched to using this. I want to save some of my better weapon, powered weapons for things that are going to count. Don't really have much more I want to do up here, apart from maybe look for more long sticks. I really hope we get the sensor at some point, because then I can just run around scrying for them, basically. Constantly have locate object on for long sticks. I can do some more cooking from here. Bit. I finally got one of those. Holy peanuts, what are you guys called? Forest Ostrich. That one has a long stick. I want it. I need to find Hetsu. I am running out of room for some of this stuff. Alright, don't really care for these things, so. I could combine that with the ruby. Got a fire staff, I suppose. I already have one though. A little sword, anyway. Alright. Back down to Lookout's Landing. And now, I guess I have to decide where I'm going to go now. So, ever means are apparently what those treants are called. Start heading towards Hebra, I guess, because that's where they seem to want me to head first. Yeah, let's do that. We've wandered around for quite a bit on this so far, so we'll travel here just to get a bit closer. Here. Carrick Bridge. Right. In the previous game, you could, if you're stealthy enough, you could sneak up on them, go in their hand, they'd put you on their chest, and you could steal the items they have there. Let's run away. That cave was a good place to hide. There's no way you can fit in there, but there might be something else living out there. He's lost interest. Sure. Ran into a few of those. That's another thing near Eldon, apparently. Alright. Well, I do know a thing or two about caves. Like lakes. Well, hang on. I've been wanting to give... Where is it? These a try. Okay, so yeah, they're fighting each other, sort of. It's just they're not very good at it, apparently. Let's see how I feed it one, too. Alright, so that works. It's just that these things aren't very good at it. I don't want to get too close to these things. Yeah, these construct bows do not last very long. Whoa! Alright! So they fight exactly like a... Okay! So yeah, they fight exactly how it looks like they should fight. Emitter shield broke. Those aren't very good. I'm going to just notice there. What about this? Alright, a lot of my usual tricks don't work on these things. I'll come back later for those. Mostly I wanted to go in there to avoid getting eaten by a Hinox. There are the horses. There's Beetle. Someone from Kakariko Village, by the looks of it. Hello. We're not sure at the moment. Alright, let's go talk to Impa. Missing some wheels. Gonna sell some stuff to Beetle and see what he has on sale.
Yeah.
I think his nose is going redder. Yeah. Sell this one, Matt.
Wow!
Alright, what do you have? Well, I'll take the arrows.
Wow! Yay! Wow!
I'll take the fire fruit. Basically, be out of money again. Also, I forgot to switch back to using these. Alright, let's talk to Impa. And apparently, she's going to have something to tell us about these Nazca lines. Not as surprised as I am to see that you're still alive, honestly. Maybe because Pyrrha looks like an adult now. Off doing her own thing, apparently. There, does that fix it? Sure, let's go take a look. I have a hot air balloon.
Oh.
Too high up, I feel faint.
Hmm.
Looks like a Zonai, kind of. I cannot take a picture from here. Okay, she managed to get down here before I did somehow. Tier. That sounds interesting. But there's a shrine right here, so I'm going to do this first. Noticed that, yeah. They have an energy drain effect. Ah! More of the balloons. Just in case it wasn't obvious how to use these, I guess. In the middle. Oh! Well, I didn't position it quite correctly, but it's easy working. Torch, right? Do I actually need that here? Let's see. Place that underneath. Not quite underneath. What was the point of coming up here, though? Thank you. Alright, this seems to make... Alright. Yeah. Attach that to that. And then hope that these things can carry the weight of. But if I do it that way, it's going to tricky. I assume this opens the way out. Yes. And the larger one is going to open that. Alright. I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that I'm going to need more than one of these. I also probably need that to be positioned a lot better. Let's try attaching these first. Enough lift. What if I put another one on top? Working. It's not very quick, but it's working. All right. comes into... There we go. Now that we've done that, let's go take a look at these Nazca lines, which Impa seems to think has something to do with. Well, the most likely spot I can think of to find a tear would be in an eye. Looks like a tear. A pulsating tear. Ah, Zelda. Oh, are these more memories again? It looks like it.
What? Oh dear.
Raru. Don't know who that is.
Where am I? We didn't mean to startle you. I'm sorry. It's okay. My name is Sonia.
Sonia?
And could we ask what your name is?
I am the daughter of King Rome of Hyrule, Zelda.
What an unexpected answer. We are the king and queen who founded Hyrule, after all. Or at least we were the last time I checked.
You two founded Hyrule? And you're the king?
My name is Raru. King Raru of Hyrule.
King Raru? And Queen Sonia?
So Zelda's in the past at the moment?
Well, that must mean...
Right. Alright, well, I was heading to Hebra anyway. Oh dear! They've weaponized a battle talus. Okay. I'm not sure I'm gonna really get that. It's pouring rain at the moment. Also, I'm not entirely sure how well this is gonna go either, going into this tower. Alright! Well, that's a thing, apparently. You have a look of someone who's lost their maracas again. Do I have to get them back for you yet again? Yes, we met before. I'm guessing he does not remember us. Yes, I have them. I do. Always start with the weapon stash. This is a bit more complicated this time. Was enough. Excellent. I can see why they recommend you head this way first. Apparently, two is the limit. It was last time as well, I think. Right in the head, I got one green ruby. Alright, let's see if we can get this tower. Maybe it'll be slightly easier to get, considering this is the direction they recommend we go. Well, it's not raining, at least. Position that under there. I should be able to send the rest of the way, I think. Alright! That worked. Sort of. Lindor's Brow Skyview Tower. Second tower, let's expand the map. It's a really long cable. Link, get scanning. Service map updated. Now the Tabantha Frontier. Sky map updated. That looks interesting. What's this over there? I don't know if I'm gonna be able to make it there. Maybe. I think I have a stamina elixir. I'm gonna try and make it to that island. The island that looks like it has a Stargate on it. Sundalion. Alright. Oh, it's kind of more of an Ouroboros than a Stargate. What's this do? Maybe it was a Stargate. Courage Island. Hyrule Ridge Sky. What does... Okay. Oh, it's one of these things. Get out of all that. A shrine. All right. Let's go take a look at this and then we'll call it for today. Is this one of the ones where you did something impressive so you just get a free one? Or is there a puzzle in here too? I'm just curious, mostly. Combat training archery. Alright, this doesn't look too difficult then. Heed my instructions, okay. I already know how to do the midair thing. Your other attacks are ineffective here. Ready yourself, okay. Ow! Hold on. Alright, I'm gonna drop this because it's near breaking point anyway. The Zonite Sword. There was a way of destroying the item you have the material attached to, as opposed to just destroying the material you fused it with. Because... just to give this a try, I assume this isn't going to be good. 12. Make another one, I guess. Alright, let's go take a look and see what I got. Strong construct bow. I'll pass for the moment, mostly because we're running out of time. Alright! And this is where we're going to pick up next week, because we've gone way over time here. There's a lot of things, interesting things happening once that I wanted to do. Thank you for watching, everyone. Please remember to like and subscribe, and please join me here again next time where we continue along our way towards Hebra, by the sounds of it. Also, we might do whatever this challenge is I'm talking about. But it does sound like it's exactly what we just did. Goodbye, everyone.